Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So this is the days of the Hijjah, the best days of our life, the days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established the religion of Islam, the days that the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam traveled all the way from Iraq to Palestine. This is 4,000 years ago. You know, to that, you know, 4,000 years ago, to go from here to Lower Hutt, it's a travel. Yeah, 100 years ago, from here to Lower Hutt, you used to take 4 hours on the cart, if you're lucky. 4,000 years ago, don't even start to think about how difficult it was to travel from Iraq through all these cultures, all the way to go in the middle of the desert and build, subhanAllah, the obedience and the submission to Allah. Any one of us, the young and the old, will tell Allah, it's a desert, build it in Cairo, with the Niles, there is life, there is civilization, build it in Rome, build it in Persia, these empires. You're taking me to the middle of nowhere to build a masjid? And on top of this, call the Azan. Once he finished building it, Allah says to him, وَأَذِّن فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ. Call mankind now. Subhanallah, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, he says to Allah, my voice won't reach. Why? My voice is not going to reach because there's nobody nearby. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you do the call and I will deliver. Subhanallah. I will deliver to the souls and the hearts of all the believers. And subhanAllah, almost every street on earth have somebody that gone to Hajj. Or somebody is really longing to go to Hajj. Yeah? Every street, every village on the face of the earth. Millions and millions every year for the last, as back as goes in history. SubhanAllah. This is the house. You're looking at the Kaaba there. And that view from this picture, there's a picture there for the camera. There's a picture, the amazing picture. Is similar to what you see from Ghar Hira, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to reflect and look. This was go up in the cave. That's what you see, Mecca. You see the Kaaba, subhanallah, from the view. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at that view when he was forced to leave Mecca, and he says, "Wallahi, innaki la ahabbu biladillah ilallah." You are the most beloved place to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you are the most beloved place to me. It's only because I'm forced to leave, I'm leaving. Subhanallah. Can you imagine the emotions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the Sahaba that left their home? This is their home. In all 1,400 years ago, it was not even, possible to live in another village. Because that's your identity, that's your tribe, that's your life. There's no IDs. You are protected by your own tribe. Once you leave, you can become a slave. They buy you and sell you in the market, no matter who you are. And the story of Umm Salama radiallahu anha, we tell the story tonight of Umm Salama radiallahu anha. When she became Muslim, her husband is Muslim, Abu Salama, and her son, they want to go to Medina. They want to leave Mecca to go to Medina to practice Islam, just to pray freely. And her family won't let her go. Her family ambushed them when they're traveling, the family, the father, the mother, and the son, Umm Salama, Abu Salama, and the child. Her own tribe ambushed them and says to him, you can go anywhere you like, but this is our woman. You can't take her. And they dragged the camel with them, and they went to their area. You can't do nothing. He went by himself, Abu Salama. But when his own tribe heard what happened, they went and attacked the wife tribe. They say, the son is ours then. You take your wife, you take the woman, the son is ours. And she's narrating, she says, two big tribes fighting for that baby, they almost, pulled the arms apart. So she said, just don't, to her tribe, leave him, otherwise he's gonna die in this country. Just let him go. Can you imagine now a mother lost her husband somewhere, her son somewhere else, and she just literally is gone very, 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 very upset. sitting, she said, 16 months in the streets of Mecca crying every day, just asking them, please let me go. Subhanallah, let me leave. I'll leave everything for you. Subhanallah, this is what we're celebrating. This is what the people go and reflecting on. When Brother Hassan looks and says, the memory, every one of us have memory, subhanAllah, for one visit, two visits. Imagine the Sahaba who lived all the life there. After 16 months, somebody from her tribe says, don't you have heart? Come on, this woman is killing herself with grief. Let her go. So this is okay, she can go and join her husband. When the tribe of her husband heard, they brought that baby. Yeah, you can take him. Now it's getting more dramatic now. She's going to travel in the desert by herself. Allah, who's the bravest here? You turn the lights off and everybody will be... yeah? In the desert for 2 weeks. Can you... Wallah, the commandos, the strongest of the elite forces, this is where they train them. Yeah? And they give them all the equipment. And she's a woman by herself, willing to travel for the sake of Allah, for Islam, no matter what she is facing, she's going to take her baby and go. Subhanallah. And she was not far from, but maybe 20 kilometers from Mecca. She is going for it. And somebody coming back home from travel, and he saw the camel by its camel, one camel, one woman on the camel. And he's from Mecca. He says, where are you going? She says, I'm going to join my husband. He says, I know where your husband is. He's in Medina. He's 500 kilometers away. Nobody with you. She said, nobody with me. The story is... She told him a story. He says, wallahi, you can't go by yourself. I will accompany you. I'll protect you. I'll be your guard. And he didn't go home. He's 20 kilometers from home, coming from travel. He turns around and takes her to Medina. And she swears by Allah, she says, wallahi, there's nobody, you know, if you don't compare with Muslim, there is nobody better than this man. Every time we need a rest, he will lower the camel, tie it up, and walk away before I get off. And he goes far away. When time comes, he will make the noise, then she gets up on the camel, then he comes and hold the camels and keep going. When he arrived, that he can see Medina on a distance, he says, your husband will be in this place. And he turns back. What a noble man, subhanAllah. What a nobility of somebody doing this. This is, they call it, you know, 1,000 years ago. And he goes back home. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never, Allah is more generous. If you do something, Allah will do you more, will give you more. This person, he became one of the last people to make hijrah to Medina. He was not Muslim. He is from Mecca, from those who rejected Islam for even 20 years. 20 years he didn't go. Subhanallah. But in the eight, just before Mecca became Muslim, month before Mecca became Muslim, Khalid ibn al-Walid says, that's it, Islam must be the truth. I'm going to Medina. I'm going to join Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on this. But he said, I can't go by myself, I need a company. I need somebody to come with me. So he goes and asks the elite also. He asks Abu Sufyan, he asks Ikrimah ibn Abu Jahl, and both of them say, what? What? You know, you're talking to the royal, going to submit? No way. They come to me, I don't go to them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed this person. The same person who took Umm Salama to Medina and came back as act of generosity, act of nobility. 8 years later, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded him and he went with Khalid ibn Walid. In the way, they met Amr ibn al-As, three, like the cream of the society, the, you know, the best of the best. The three, can you imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seeing them come on the distance? He told them, this is the best of Mecca came to you. Khalid ibn Walid, Amr ibn al-As, and our companion of this story, amazing story. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a few months after they arrive in Medina, he goes to Mecca and Mecca becomes Muslim. Now they used to stop the Muslim and torture them and kill them, not to stop them from going near the Kaaba. You can't go near it. You have to watch, you know, they have idols in As-Safa, idols in Al-Marwa, idols everywhere. Now the Kaaba become Muslim. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, where is the keys to the Kaaba? Now the Muslim will have the keys. And Ali once said, and Abbas once said, they want to have the, this is the most honored place on the face of the earth throughout history. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called that man's name. The same man, Uthman ibn Talha. He says, where is Uthman ibn Talha? Among the 12,000 people, he's calling, where is Uthman ibn Talha? And Uthman ibn Talha came and he gave him the key. He says, this will stay with you till the end of time. Till today, that key of the Kaaba in the children and the offspring of Uthman ibn Talha, till today, with them. The king of Saudi, when he wants to go inside, he will give permission from them. They come, they open the key, he can go inside. This is the story of this place. This is the Kaaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba, men, women, and children sacrificed. That's what we're celebrating, and that's why we're Muslim, alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invite us to Mecca and Medina many times in our life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to invite us to Hajj and Umrah many times in our life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our iman. We ask Allah to increase our iman. We ask Allah to increase our iman. We ask Allah to love us and love our families. To protect us, to protect our family. To defend us and to defend our families. We ask Allah to bless us and bless our families. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Jazakum Allah khairan.